Hi everyone, it's Vicky here with my monthly feature creating 10 cards using a Simon Says Stamp card kit. For a chance to win the July card kit by Simon Says Stamp, make sure to visit my blog and enter the giveaway. So let's take a quick look on what's inside the kit first. In your kit you will find 4 different colors of ink cubes. These are hybrid ink cubes by Simon Says Stamp and they are great stash builders. You will also get your lollipop just like every month. There are also 2 watercolor papers. There is a stamp set full of flowers and nice sentiments, a nice watercolor brush with a fine tip which I really liked, of course your pattern papers. They are all double-sided and they are really thick. You can actually use them as a card base if you want to. And of course you get your cardstock, 2 white ones and 3 colors that match perfectly the pattern papers that come in the kit. So just like I do every time, I am going to cut the cardstock in half and then fold them so I can create out of it 10 different card bases, which I am then going to decorate. So let's start with the first card. I am going to use the watercolor paper that was included in the kit and I am going to chop off 1/4 inch from each side. This way it's going to be slightly smaller than a standard cut, so I get a nice frame when I stick it on top of my card base. Now I am going to stamp on this watercolor paper, so I am preparing first the surface with my powder tool so the embossing powder doesn't stick all over, and I'm going to stamp the flower. You won't be able to see anything at this stage since I am using Versamarking, but when I tilt the card just a little bit I can see where I have stamped. So I am going to move on and emboss the stamped image, so then I can move on and do some masking. The plan is to create an arrangement of flowers and leaves, and that's why I need to stop and do some masking, because I want some of the leaves to be behind the flowers. So I have stamped this on a masking paper. I'm going to mask the flower and then stamp around it to create my little scene. Now that I have my arrangement there, it's time to add some color, and for that I am going to be using my Zig watercolor pens today. So I am going to apply a little bit of water with the brush that was included in the kit. I'm just making sure that everything is nice and wet. And then just by using only one watercolor marker and the brush, I'm going to create all the shading that I need. And again I'm working wet on wet, that means I'm first wetting the leaf and then applying the color. This gives me the opportunity to move the color easier and to create the shading as you can see now. I did the same technique for all the leaves and now I'm going to show you how I colored the flowers. So first I am applying a little bit of color on a stamping block, and with my brush I am going to color all the flower. This is going to give me the opportunity to see what I'm doing, because at this stage I couldn't see where all those little petals are. So now that I have the color there, I can go ahead and use my marker and add some shading only on the base of each petal. This is going to blend nicely because each and every petal is wet at this stage. But you will see that once I finish adding that shading, I am going to go over it a little bit with my brush, just to make sure that everything is nicely blended. And that's the exact same technique that I did to color the rest of the flowers. When I am making the 10 cards out of one card kit, I try to keep the cards simple so that I don't use too many products from my stash, and mainly use products from the kit. And however, sometimes those cards end up really quick and easy to make, and others are more time consuming, just like the one that I am making today, not because I am using too many supplies, but just because it has all that coloring. So now it's time to stamp the sentiment, and I am going to use one of the ink cubes that was included in the kit, and this is the color slate. And once that's there, I am going to stick that directly on top of a card base. I am going to stick it on the slate card base so it matches the sentiment, the color of the sentiment. And my card is finished. You will see close-up photos of all the cards that I'm making at the end of the video. So now let's move on to the second card. For my second card, I did the same trick, so I have chopped off a quarter of an inch from each side to make it slightly smaller than a standard card. And now I'm using this post-it tape, and I have masked off a part of the card. So now I am going to stamp using the flowers and the leaves again, and I am going to make sure that I stamp on top and at the bottom of this post-it masking tape. I am going to create my arrangement. I am using black archival ink, and I am stamping everything with archival ink just because I want to make sure that nothing is going to smear or smudge while I am coloring, because I am planning again to use my Zig watercolor markers. And I always like this part when I peel off the mask and see the result. So I am going to see how it looks now, and at the center where that blank space is, I am going to stamp the sentiment. And I have found that when I am stamping on watercolor paper with archival ink, although the watercolor paper is so textured, I get a really nice impression, making sure that all the ink is dry, so I can move on and color. Again, I'm going to use, just like I told you, my Zig watercolor markers, and this time I'm not going to use the brush, the watercolor brush, but I'm going to blend directly with the markers. So I'm using two different colors, a lighter and a darker one, and you see how nicely they blend. But remember, this technique doesn't work if you are working on a non-watercolor cardstock. So I did everything the same way, color the flowers and the leaves, and now I'm going to add some tiny little dots here and there just to make it a little bit more whimsical. To stamp those, I am using one of the watercolor markers that I have used previously. So you can see that even with those you can stamp, just apply it on your stamp, and you get a nice watercolor effect. So by adding those little dots here and there, are going to fill in some gaps that I feel I had, just to balance the stamping and the whole image. And you can call the card done at this stage, but I just had to add a little bit of my white gel pen at the tips of the petals as well as on the flowers. I think that this detail helps them pop even more. Now, I have to apologize about the focus at this stage. It's going to come back and look nice in a bit. So I decided that I needed a little bit of dimension, because I don't know why I cannot stay away from dimension for my cards. I just can't make a flat card. So I am using my craft knife, and I'm going around the leaves so that I can pop them up. I'm going to use my scoring board so that I can score a straight line, and this way I can lift up the leaves so that they look nice and dimensional. I'm going to do the exact same thing with the rest of the leaves. I was thinking to do the same thing with the flowers, but it was too tricky, so I decided not to. So now I have a nice and dimensional card that I am going to stick directly on the slate cardstock by using my tape adhesive. If you are planning to send this card through the mail, then I would advise to add a few foam squares at the back of the leaves so that they don't end up totally flat. For my third card, I'm going to cut out a piece of this beautiful pattern paper with this stitched die, and I'm going to stamp on another piece of pattern paper the sentiment "Missing You", which I have cut out with a circle die. I'm adding some foam squares at the back, and I'm going to stick it directly on top of the panel. This is a super easy and quick card, but I think that sometimes the paper has such nice designs that you don't really need to do anything more. Now, if you want to take this card a step further, you can always use your Wink of Stella clear glitter pen. I am adding a little bit of shine on the flowers, and I did add some shine on the sentiment as well. And to finish it off, I am going to use some glossy accents on the flowers, and this is going to create something interesting on the card so that it's not that plain. I'm going to show you the finished result once that was dry, so you can see the effect. Really nice for a simple card. So now let's move on to the fourth card. This pattern paper has two borders, one on top and one at the bottom, which I'm going to chop off, and I'm going to use my scissors and cut around them. I'm going to make sure that I leave a nice white border all around as I am cutting, and I'm going to do this for both the borders, so I end up with two scalloped edges and the middle white panel. Now I plan to stick that on top of my yellow card base, and I am going to cut it out to size. I always like to stick things on top of my card base that are slightly smaller, because I think that having a nice border all around helps the card to look more finished. So now I am going to chop off the scalloped borders as well, and then the plan is to pop them up on the card. You know I love dimension by now, so I am going to stick one on top of the other by using foam tape at the back. And when I'm making a simple card such as this or the previous one, I always try to find a way to use the pattern paper in a creative way so that I can add just a little bit of dimension or interest here and there. So I am going to double up on foam tape for the second scallop edge so that it stays just a little bit on top of the first one. And my card is pretty much finished. All that's left to do is to stamp the sentiment. So I'm going with "Missing You" for this one. And now let's move on to the next card. For this card, I'm going to combine these two beautiful papers, and I'm going to cut out a panel out of this first one, and I'm also going to use my scissors and cut out two of the flowers from this pattern paper. I am planning to stick them on top of the other panel, and of course I'm going to use foam squares at the back to add the dimension that I always seek for. So I don't really care if those flowers are not full, because I am again going to stick them at the edges. I am also going to create the sentiment now. So to do so, I'm just going to stamp one of the sentiments from the stamp set on a piece of scrap white cardstock. To stamp my sentiment, I've used the ink cube from the kit that is called Steel Blue, and it matches perfectly the color of the card. So again, I have used some foam squares at the back, and I'm going to stick it on my panel. I used my scissors to cut out the excess paper, and I'm going to stick that on my white cardstock. So just to finish it off, I'm going to use a couple of pearls at the center of the flowers. And my card is finished. This is a leftover from the previous card where I have cut out this circle, and I am going to cut out a panel from what's left out of this. I am going to use the scissors and cut out those little circles. This way I have some elements that they match perfectly the background panel that I can pop out on my card. I'm going to use the ink cubes and ink up the edges of the panel as well as my card base, and you will see that at this stage I decided to go with a yellow card base for my card, but I am going to change my mind at the end. So anyway, I am inking up the edges with a purple one, and then with the yellow I'm going to ink up the edges of my card base. Once that's done, I have used a circle die to cut out a few of those circles, which I am again going to color with the same colors I did for the edge inking. Now I'm planning to use those to create some flowers. So I'm adding a little bit of movement there to just make them three-dimensional. I'm going to sandwich in between a piece of vellum, and on top I'm going to add the cutouts from the pattern paper. So I'm going to stick one on top of the other to create my flowers by using a matte gel medium, and you can see one of those flowers here. I'm going to repeat the process to create three different flowers. Again, I'm using my matte medium to stick everything together. And I needed some stems for my flowers, so I'm just cutting out thin strips from this scrap pattern paper. And this is where I decided that I liked better this panel against the white card base instead of that yellow one that I have prepared previously. So just to bind everything together, I went with white stems for my flowers. So now I am using glue dots to stick everything down. And with the glue pen, I am adding a little bit of glue at the back of the thin strips of paper, which I am going to stick straight down from the flowers. So I'm creating my little arrangement there. To finish off the flowers, I'm adding some black gems at the center of the flowers, and I'm also going to use my scissors and cut out the excess paper. I am going to use foam squares at the back, and I'm going to stick the panel directly on top of my white card base. As a sentiment, I decided to go with this very, very small one that says "For You", and it comes from an old stamp set by Simon Says Stamp. But of course you can use any of the sentiments that are included in the kit and just stamp it on your card. And that finishes the card. I'm going to show you a close-up now, so you can see all the dimension that I have achieved. And now let's move on to the seventh card. And since we have to be frugal with the supplies from the kit, this is a leftover from a previous card. I'm going to cut off the paper that is not straight, and I'm going to do a nice technique here. So I'm cutting with my paper trimmer up to the flower, and now with my scissors I'm going to cut out around the flower, so I have a nice part of the flower that goes outside that straight line. I am going to do the exact same technique on the other part, on the other side of the flower, so I have a nice panel, as you can see, with parts of the flower that goes outside. Now from this pattern paper I'm going to cut out a piece that's 4.25 by 5.5, so that I can cover up the mess that I have created from the previous card, where I decided to ink up those edges and it didn't work out at the end. So now everything is nicely covered. I have the panel there that I'm going to cut out a little bit at the top, so that it is exactly 5.5. And I am going to use some foam tape at the back to add a little bit of dimension. At the center of my flower, I'm going to stick a pearl, just to add a nice element there. And for the sentiment, I decided to go with this Hello die cut. This is from an old Simon Says stamp collection, but you can pretty much use any die cut that you have, or you can even stamp one of the sentiments that are included in the stamp set from this month's kit. I really love this Hello die, and since I had it on my table, you will see that I am going to use it in three different cards today. To finish it off, I am using some Wink of Stella clear glitter pen, and this is where I decided that I needed a darker edge to separate more the banner from the background, and that's why I have cut out these thin strips of paper from a dark blue cardstock from my stash, and I'm just placing them underneath so that only a hair of this blue shows, but I think that finishes off the card really nice. So now let's move on to the 8th card. For this card I am stamping my flowers and leaf. I am using Memento Tuxedo Black ink at this stage, just because I'm planning to use my Copic markers to color everything. I have also die cut a tag, and I am going to stamp the sentiment from the bottom towards the top as if it is the stem of the flower. So I'm going to do some quick coloring with my Copic markers. You can use pretty much any coloring medium that you love. I'm doing some shading there quickly. I'm not paying too much attention. And I'm going to color the leaves as well. And actually I'm going to make two different flowers. And I'm going to cut one smaller than the other so that I can pop one on top of the other to create a little bit of dimension. I'm going to decide where I want that leaf to be, as if it is coming outside of the sentiment, which is the stem in this situation. And I'm going to give a little bit of curl on those paper flowers, just to make them more dimensional. And with a foam square, I'm going to stick one on top of the other. And since I had all those pearls on my desk from the previous cards, I just had to stick one at the center. Before sticking the leaves directly on top of the tag, I used a green Copic color marker just to make sure that when you look underneath the popped up leaf, you don't see just an empty space. So I'm securing the leaves with foam squares. I have also used my crocodile to create a hole there and to place an eyelet. And now I'm going to stick the flower on top. And my tag is pretty much ready. I decided to go with the pink card base, and just because it was so plain, I am using a few of the tiny little dots and flowers that come in the stamp set. And with my Versamark ink, I am just inking the background. And I'm not going to do any embossing, I'm not going to apply any embossing powder. I just went for that tone-on-tone look that the Versamark gives on my cardstock. I have used foam squares at the back, and I'm going to stick it on top of my card base. And this is going to finish off the card. So let's move on to the 9th card for today. And this is where I am seriously running out of supplies from the kit. So I'm going to use this pattern paper as my background, and from the leftovers, after cutting it out, I'm going to create some banners. So again, I am using the same idea, using parts of the pattern paper to add a little bit of dimension. So you see, I am going to use a couple of those strips of paper. I'm going to stick those banners on top of the panel, just to make it a little bit more interesting and add some detail there so that it doesn't look as plain. Now, as the sentiment, again, since I had that hello on my table, I have cut it out of black cardstock, and I'm going to stick it directly at the center of my panel. Now this is going to bind nicely with the black splashes that this pattern paper has. And to finish it off, I used my gold Wink of Stella glitter pen at the yellow areas. I hope you can see the glitter there. And this is the only pattern paper that I had by now. So I have cut out a panel out of it. Again, I'm using the same die that says hello from my stash. I have cut it out of black cardstock and I'm just using some scrap white cardstock to stick it on top. And now I am going to use one of the leaves from the stamp set and I'm going to stamp it at the end of the letter O as if it is coming out of it. So I'm using a very thin black marker to finish off the edge there. And I really, really love this effect. Now I am going to die cut this with one of my Mama Elephant speech borders. I'm using some tape adhesive at the back of the panel and I'm going to stick it on the last card base that I have left that's happened to be white. So I was planning to go for this card as it is now, but then I decided that I had two empty space there. So I looked for a little bird in my stash and I end up using this little bird by Lone Phone. I used black ink to stamp the bird. I have cut it out and I'm not going to color it so that it matches perfectly the black and white leaf at my sentiment. So let's take a quick look on all the cards that I have created for today. And you see that some of them are really involved. You need to take a lot of time to finish them off, such as the second card or this one with the flowers. But there are others that they are really, really quick to do and recreate, easy to recreate. So let's take a look at what's left on my card kit after creating all those 10 cards. So the 4 ink cubes, the stamp set, as well as the brass are going directly on my stash. And I think I made a great use of this kit since I'm pretty much left with only those scraps. So here are some close-up photos of all the cards that I have created today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And if you need more inspiration, here are 2 more videos where I am creating 10 cards using previous card kits by Simon Says Stamp. Thank you all for watching!